What's up, guys? It's Acid Glow here. So we're back in Aliens vs. Predator. So this is the classic version from 1999. So this is on Steam. So I just picked this game recently because I want to try it out with my new laptop, because I'm pretty sure you could handle it. So this is a full HD playthrough I'll do with the Predator, the Marine, and the Alien. And I think I'll do some live commentary with the Marine, because I think that one is the most fun, because it is like the scariest one out of the three campaigns. When it comes to, I'd say, the Alien, that one is not really creepy at all, because you're pretty much playing as like the stalking alien. You know, you're climbing the walls and ceilings trying to find these Marines down below, and then all you gotta do is like tail whip them pretty much. And as for the Predator, he does have a bunch of stealth with his camouflage and his long range spear gun. The funny thing is, they actually changed the spear gun to a different way, like how it functions in Alien vs. Predator 2. Like in AVP 2, it was changed to like, it was still a sniper weapon, but it would not decloak you, but you can only get a one hit kill through a headshot. And the little like spear tips that the spear gun shot in AVP 2, they were not like instantaneous shots like they are in AVP 1. No, in AVP 2, there was actually some traveling speed, because they were like airborne projectiles. They were not instantaneous bullets, you know, like from the pulse rifle, smart gun, and the minigun. So getting headshots in AVP 2 was actually pretty hard, because enemies were a little bit slower, but because there was a delay of your shot getting to where you're aiming, that made it harder. But the secondary fire on the spear gun was like a randomly shooting triple shot spear shot in a way. It shot three shots, but they were always like in random locations wherever you're aiming, but it was kind of okay. So anyways, back to AVP 1. I forget what the hell this level was. I just don't remember what it was exactly. I do want to point out that I don't know if I still have this video, but I might have taken it down over the past few years when I uploaded it, but they actually had an uncut version of the Predator's introduction movie sequence. Like before you start the first level, there's a little introduction of a Marine getting spied on from behind, and that's a cloaked Predator. And then the camera shifts from the back of his boot to his back, and then to the front, and then you see like the cloaked Predator behind him, and then he shoots like a plasma bolt. But when it hits the Marine, it's off screen. But the uncut version was actually showing his like head just exploded with blood, and like the bone matter and everything just like kind of like went everywhere. So there was an uncut version of it originally in the game, but I guess that was way too gory for 1998. So they actually released a different version, well, more like an updated version of Alien vs. Predator Classic. So the original one from 1999 was just called Aliens vs. Predator. Then I believe in 2000 they updated it and called it Alien vs. Predator Gold Edition. And that pretty much just had a bunch of new multiplayer maps in there. Like, alongside the ones that shipped with the original game, there were a bunch of other ones they made, and there were like really cool ones in there. And they also brought, like, I believe, dual pistols for the Marine to use in multiplayer. I don't remember if you can use dual pistols in single player, but it didn't really matter, because if I remember correctly, in multiplayer, the pistols were god awful because they were just so weak. There was really no point to use them. Now, the multiplayer is something I do want to try to get back into in this game on Steam. I did play the original AVP in 99 and the Gold Edition as well. And I played the Gold Edition on GameSpy Arcade. That was so long ago. It's like over 10 years ago. But man, the memories of that game online were so fun, because the game wasn't really balanced, because it was released during the Quake era. So by that I mean the Quake era was like where first-person shooters were all very fast-paced, and there were a lot of one-hit kill weapons or a lot of power weapons. So anyways, in this game, the best weapons for the Predator are the spear gun and the shoulder cannon and the disc. but the disc is like the cheapest gun, and a lot of people in the multiplayer community really hate Predator players that actually use the disc because it is so hard to dodge, especially for Marine. Because the way they have it in this game is the disc locks on, and then when you throw it, it actually has really good turning capabilities. So it doesn't just go in a straight line, it curves in midair, and it actually turns a lot. Like, a lot, I'm telling you. So it actually turns a lot, and it can still come back and kill the Marine. And I believe it turns like 180 degrees, like a full half circle if it misses. So there's a really good chance it'll hit a Marine player from like out in the open. But if you're in like a stage that has a bunch of corridors, you can kind of like possibly just like shift to the side of like a hallway and it'll just like miss. Like it'll go down that previous hallway. The Predator pistol is more meant for dealing with aliens. That's all it's meant for, really. You might want to use that if you don't want to hurt yourself with the shoulder cannon charge shots. Oh, watch this. Watch this right here. You see that Marine that just walked in front of me? That was the one that was shooting me from the right side when I walked in there. And then when I backed up and he walked in front of the doorway, I was like, oh man, I felt dumb. It's like that Marine was just like mocking me right there. It just looked so funny when I saw it. I was like, what? What is hitting me? The Marine in the back could not be shooting me that many times. And then I see this one Marine just casually walk right in front of me. I'm like, okay. Okay, yeah, that was funny. So, this game does have androids. They're going to appear as white targets in the red vision, which is what you see right now. So, most of them pretty much come equipped with a shotgun. You don't really see too many when you use the Predator. I think this is like the only one I run into in the entire campaign. And I think you're going to run into more of these androids while you're using the Alien, because I think they put up more of a fight than the Marines, because the Marines tend to get scared pretty easily in this game. So, anyways, we're at the end of this video, so stay tuned for part 3, and I will see you guys later on.